RWBY, what are we doing?
We're introducing the final RWBY production diary!
Do we have to?
Don't worry, girls, we've already started! Hello, everyone! This week, the RWBY crew discusses post-production, including rendering, compositing, and sound design. Isn't that cool?
I guess. Sure.
Hey, where's the best character in RWBY? Yang! Yang! Yang!
To the RWBY crew, post-haste! Get it? Post.
So the animators spend their time on building up the performances of the characters in the shot, but not necessarily the final look. The shot does not look like its final form right off of our render farm.
I work with Monty very closely to decide how we want to organize all of our assets and our files, our textures, and basically just sort of set up the home in which our show is going to live. What we do in animation is such a contradiction in so many ways. Essentially, we're trying to create organized art, and art is not organized by its very nature.
That's why it's perfect!
Jeff does a tremendous amount of scripting that animators use to save time, so very repetitive technical steps that instead of the animator having to constantly perform these tasks, Jeff is writing tools that they can use to offload a lot of that, so that's pretty cool.
Scripting is essentially using a computer language to dictate a bunch of commands to the computer that can be repeated over and over and over again. And while that doesn't sound very exciting, it's very powerful. Things that would normally take many hours or even minutes that add up can be done in seconds.
Like we run physics on the hair. Sometimes it's way exaggerated because the physics engine, it just goes crazy sometimes. He's able to automate that for us. So now we have a script called a key editor. So we can run the physics, open the key editor, and then highlight the channels we want all at once instead of having to do it one at a time. And we just click a button once and then done.
One of the other things that we've been able to integrate this season, which has been a lot of fun, is lighting.
You know, so last season we lit things very flatly so that we could edit later. But this season Jeff has gone out of his way to, you know, light pretty much every set that we have in a way, you know, we've got the shadows in there, everything looks really nice, which is, you continue to strive toward Monty's goal, which is straight out of pose or we're done.
And that's added a lot of depth to the environment in general, but it has also allowed us to add shadows that connect the characters to the sets. Everything we're doing is creating 2D images. That's all we're doing, is just frames. They may be animated as one cohesive unit, but when it gets to render, they have to be broken up into separate elements, so that way we can pass them off to compositing for post-production.
Basically, they take the shot and they break it up into layers so that I can then manipulate them further.
So I'm mainly in charge of rendering the show, which means I take the file from the animators and I break that down into different passes. So for instance, the shot of RWBY in the cafeteria, that shot has RWBY. So it has trees outside, so you can see those. It has a background. It has windows, so you can see the sky through the windows. It has a crowd behind her. It has sunlight. It's not just the lighting in the set, but it has an effect pass for the sunlight. Once we have those passes set up, a composite puts them back together.
Compositing is kind of a big subject that kind of depends on what project you're working on. For us, our main goal is to add a unique look to a show, or in this case, keep a consistent look throughout the show. One of the things that we try and do is we will flatten things, you know, we add what we call depth of field. It's really just blurring the background most of the time. One thing that Monty really established in the original character trailers was this look for the show that is, you know, very vibrant colors. It's got this bloom to it, but so everything, like, it just feels like it's radiating light in its own, you know, its own way.
We are starting to experiment more with doing more of the visual effects actually back in Poser. We've got visual effects actually in Engine, so they've done more animated looking dust hits when a character hits the ground or explosions. It's not an exaggeration that sound is half the experience. So it's very important to us that enough careful focus is put on the sound experience of telling a story.
I think we are taking, you know, kind of more the animation side of things, and also taking the live action side of things that a lot of us know, and, you know, fusing them together, peanut butter and chocolate style.
You get a blend of, you know, the Chuck Jones sound effects, and then you also get sound effects that you hear in your typical anime.
Oh God.
No!
Sound has this way of subconsciously wrapping itself around the mind, especially if the motion, the action, the movement of these things has a sense of rhythm to it. Doesn't matter how ridiculous this is, I have a doorway into the mind by using sound properly.
Monty has designed all of these weapons for each of these characters, and actually, he's very meticulous about each weapon having its own unique sound.
If you ask my sound designer, it's like five different things layered in one. It's like... he hates me.
He will listen for not only the impacts, but the lead up to an impact.
But it's still very important, and you know, very easily could become sound soup if not done properly.
I'll take it in steps. So I'll break down the sequence and just take one layer at a time. First, you have efforts, and you have the vocal performances.
We gotta move!
Then you have the monster sound effects, including the pincers and how it moves. Then we have Foley, which can be anything from just weapon movement to footsteps. Then there's the ambience and the actual hits of swords and pieces of metal and just crashes. And then, of course, the last layer is the score by Jeff Williams.
We gotta move!
Jeff Williams does a really good job of being able to go between orchestral pieces mm-hmm. that can, you know, kind of subtly reinforce the emotion of the scene.
Right.
I had all this stupid macho stuff in my head.
John, it's okay.
And then he makes music videos. He makes like face-melting guitar solos and like crazy stuff that Monty's gonna just take and run with.
We put a lot of emphasis on music, especially for RWBY. I mean, animated shows kind of live or die by their soundtrack very often.
The way that we've been steering the process is we do tend to deal with leitmotifs. So different themes will crop up for different characters or locations.
You know, at the end of the day, it's motivation. It's motivation. It's like, why is this character doing this? He very often looks for reasons to write songs. He has an idea for a song he wants. When we were talking about the Red Chili, I knew Jeff would come up with something, and he did absolutely come up with something. Him and Casey together, just this dynamic pair.
Hey everybody, thank you so much for watching the RWBY Behind the Scenes Diaries. We hope you enjoyed them. Be sure to check out the versions on the DVD and Blu-ray. We'll have even more content there. And RWBY Volume 2 will premiere at RTX 2014.
Now that you've seen how it all comes together, here's a message from RWBY herself about the coming year.
Thanks from the crew here in Austin, Texas. Take care.
Sisters, friends, wives.
Hey!
4 score and 7 minutes ago, I had a dream.
This ought to be good.
A dream that one day, the four of us would come together as a team and have the most fun anyone has ever had. Ever!
Did you steal my binder?
I am not a crook.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about kicking off the semester with a bang.
I always kick my semesters off with a yang. Eh? Guys? Am I right? What?
Look, guys, it's been a good 2 weeks, and between more exchange students arriving and the tournament at the end of the year, our second semester is going to be great. But classes start back up tomorrow, which is why I've taken the time to schedule a series of wonderful events for us today.
It's okay. They're not ready for you yet. Your time will come.